हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ सैनिटेशन इन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ क्लीन एंड सेफ मिल्क. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ सैनिटेशन. मिल्क इज़ अ मेजर सोर्स ऑफ फूड फॉर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, स्पेशली फॉर इन्फेंट्स. इट इज़ ऑल्सो अ पेरिशेबल प्रोडक्ट. इट इज़ बेस्ट मीडियम फॉर द माइक्रोबियल ग्रोथ. बैक्टीरिया पैथोजेनिक एज वेल एज नॉन पैथोजेनिक ग्रो बेस्ड इन द मिल्क. Some pathogens are dangerous to human health and also spoil the milk earlier. Milk containing more amount of visible dirt and microorganisms, that milk gets spoiled. The microorganisms find their way into the milk at every stage of production and handling. To avoid such contamination, proper care must be taken at every stage of production and handling. For that, it is important to know the channels of bacterial contamination to milk. So, the primary source of bacterial contamination to milk. A. First is the animal itself. In that, interior of animal and exterior of animal. B. Milker. C. Utensils. D. Atmosphere. And E. Feed. These are the primary sources of bacterial contamination to the milk. Then the second one is the miscellaneous sources, in that flies, visitors, consumers, various ingredients added to milk. These are the miscellaneous sources for the contamination of the milk. Then we will discuss about the primary sources. Animal itself. Primary source of contamination is animal itself. Interior of animal. An unhealthy animal suffering from contagious diseases like TB, brucellosis, typhoid is the source of pathogens directly into milk within the body of animal. Okay, the unhealthy animal, those are suffering from the contagious diseases like TB, brucellosis, typhoid, these are the sources from which the pathogens directly enter into the milk within the body of animals. So the animals suffering from mastitis is also source of microorganism. Mastitis, it is the inflammation of the udder. Then milk at its secretion is free of microorganisms. As milk passes down the ducts and reservoir of udder bacteria are picked up from the walls of the duct and reservoir. Most of the bacteria get entered into the udder from the outside. After milking is completed, source of milk remained in the teat. Residual milk, which is source of food for the microorganisms. Then exterior of animal. The dust on the flanks, tail and udder is the major source of contamination to the milk. A large number of microorganisms are found in soil, animal discharges, straw, dust, etc. If such filth is on the animal body at the time of milking, dust may fall in the milk. So long hair on the udder are also responsible to carry the dust. Very small amount of dust falling in the milk would be sufficient to increase number of bacteria in milk to great extent. Animals suffering from various skin diseases like scabies, mange are sources of contamination. The parasites of skin diseases may fall in the milk at the time of milking and thus contaminate the milk. The next one is the milker. It is also a source of contamination to the milk. So how it is a source of contamination to milk, that we will discuss. So milker is the first man who comes in contact with the milk. Most of the contamination of bacteria depends upon the carelessness of the milker or dairyman. So dirty hands, long nails, dirty clothes, bad habits are the major sources of contamination. Filthy habits like wet hand milking and similar practices are responsible for the contamination of milk. Milkers suffering from contagious and skin diseases is also dangerous. Several diseases caused by bacteria like typhoid, diphtheria, scarlet fever, and septic sore throat are transmitted from diseased person to healthy through the milk. Then next one is the milking utensils. Milking utensils are a great source of contamination. There are two types of possibilities of contamination. The contamination may arise from the utensils which are unsterilized, or it may arise from water with which utensils are washed. The unsterilized milking pail, neglected milking machines, improperly washed milking utensils add countless microorganisms to the milk. The next one is the atmosphere or byre. Ill-ventilated barns, especially dusty barns, are responsible for contamination of milk by the microorganisms. Poor ventilation causes less sunlight in the barns and thus increases humidity. Such as atmosphere is very useful for the growth and multiplication of microorganisms. The next one is the feed. The feeds like decomposed material or contaminated with mold, volatile flavors, moldy hay, or grains, or badly fermented feeds are the sources of microorganisms. Then miscellaneous sources are flies. If surrounding atmosphere of the byre is suitable for the flies, a large population of flies contaminate the milk. The next is the visitors. Dirty, diseased visitors are source of contamination to the milk. Then consumers. Dirty receptacles and unsuitable storage place helps in the multiplication of bacteria present and also add fresh quota. The practice of leaving the milk uncovered to be further contaminated by the flies. It is no doubt that much milk receives its initial contamination in the house. Various ingredients added to the milk. Substances such as water, gelatin, starch, sugar, etc. added into the milk are the sources of contamination. Then we will discuss about the steps in clean milk production. So first of all, we will discuss about the definition of clean milk. What is clean milk? Clean milk is the milk produced from healthy cow or buffalo in a clean and attractive premises and with a low bacterial count, free from pathogenic organisms and having no visible dirt. That milk we call as the clean milk. So first of all, we will discuss about the healthy animals. What is meant by healthy animals? As much as certain diseases may be transmitted through milk, it is absolutely essential that all cows producing milk should be free from any infectious diseases. All cows should be free from the diseases like TB, tuberculosis, typhoid, and brucellosis. Any cow with physical disability like inflamed udder or infective udder, teats should be isolated and her milk should not be mixed with the normal milk. Then we will discuss about the clean cow. Clean milk cannot be produced from dirty cow. If the flanks, belly, udder, teat and tail of cow are soiled with manure and earth or loose hairs, considerable extraneous material will fall in the milk. Before each milking, cow should be groomed to remove to loose hairs, dirt, manure, soil or other accumulations from the body. The grooming should be completed at least half an hour before milking in order so that excessive quantity of the dirt will not be in the barn. In addition, udder and teat should be washed with wet cloth and dried with another cloth. If the udder and teats are not dried, dirty water may fall into the milk pail. This is the picture of milk pail. So most of the dirt and sediments that enter the milk drops from the body of cow during the milking process. Use of dome-shaped milk pail will keep out at least 50% of such dirt. So it is made up of aluminium. This milk pail is made up of aluminium and it can reduce the 50% of the dirt due to its dome-shaped shape. Then straining of milk. The visible dirt introduced into the milk under proper method of production will be removed by the straining. The milk should be strained on the farm as soon as it is removed from the stable before it is cooled. So the clean and healthy people, that is milker and visitors, anyone intimately connected with the production and handling of milk should be in a good health and be clean in his habits. Certain serious diseases are carried through milk which has been infected by person in contact with the milk. The milker should be free from skin and contagious diseases, should follow the correct method of milking, has no overgrown nails, free bad habits, and with clean clothing. Clean and sterilized utensils. Under ordinary farm conditions, the utensils are to be considered as greatest source of bacteria. So the clean, sterilized and dry utensils are absolute necessities in the production of milk with low bacterial count and high keeping quality. So the utensils are washed and sterilized as soon as they are used. The next one is the prompt and efficient cooling. The milk produced under clean conditions contains some bacteria. Therefore, it must be cooled as soon as possible in order to check the growth of organisms. So cooling is done by surface cooler or by putting the milk cans into cold water tanks. The next one is the prompt delivery. Milk which is intended for market purpose should be delivered promptly. Fresh, clean and cooled milk is safe for delivery. Next one is the proper construction of barns. The cleanliness of barns, particularly stalls, floors and gutters, is of vital importance. From the vital standpoint of cleanliness of cow, floors and gutters should be made from the impervious material with sufficient slope for proper drainage. Barns should be well ventilated. Next is the water. Water supply of dairy should be fresh, uncontaminated. Feed. The feed given to the cow should be of good quality and free from decomposed material fermentation. Clean premises. The manure from the stable should be removed daily and deposited at distance sufficient to prevent odor in the milking stable. It should be covered to prevent flies breeding. The milk home should be screened and the door should open outward to keep the flies from entering when the door is opened. Then we will discuss about the safe milk. What is meant by safe milk? Safe milk is the milk which is produced from healthy cow or buffalo in a clean and attractive premises, having no visible dirt and free from pathogenic as well as non-pathogenic microorganisms. So clean milk is not free from microorganisms. Hence, it is not safe for the consumption and storage. Okay, clean milk is not free from microorganisms. It is only free from the visible dirt. So clean milk, it is not safe for the consumption and storage. To increase the keeping quality of milk and make it safe for consumption, heat treatment is given. Milk is heated by boiling, pasteurization and sterilization. Boiling is done at the house. Very small quantity of milk is boiled. The keeping quality of milk is increased up to few hours. To maintain the quality of milk, it is boiled frequently. If the quantity of milk is more, it is pasteurized. Pasteurization does not kill all the microorganisms. Some microorganisms may remain alive after pasteurization, which may spoil the milk. Boiled and pasteurized milk is stored at low temperature. In sterilization, milk is heated at high temperature under the pressure. So the sterilization makes milk free from bacteria along with their spores and hence stored at room temperature for the 7 days. So thank you. This is all about this topic.